Hi friends, this is Gautam. In this video tutorial, we are going to discuss about Cisco tricky question and answers. Let's see. So this is my question. So here I am using two router R1, R2. So point to point network, I am using 10.10.10.0/30 network. In R1 router, I will create one loopback 1.1.1/24. So in R1 and R2, I am configuring EIGRP routing protocol for full reachability. So here my question is it possible to take backup configuration automatically? So whenever we can save the configuration on a router for a particular duration. So second question, if it's yes, then which concept is used to perform this task? So third question, the configuration file should be saved in your flash memory only. Don't use any external server. So fourth question, is it possible to compare the previous saved configuration and the current saved configuration file? So last point, is it possible to roll back from the current configuration to the previous configuration? So this is my question. So answer for this question is configuration archive and rollback. So using this concept, we can achieve all these questions. So we can see configuration archive and rollback. So the configuration archive can be created every time you save your running configuration, or you can create one based on your time schedule, for an example each 24 hours or so. So here what they are saying means either configuration archive will create whenever you are saving your running configuration, or so you can schedule the time window. For an example, if you schedule 24 hours means, so every 24 hours the configuration file will be saved automatically. So without giving save configuration command, example run write command or copy running hyphen config or startup hyphen config. So second point, when you have multiple snapshots, you can use show command to see the difference between the configuration and easily restore rollback to the previous version. So in this point, what they are saying is multiple snapshots means the multiple configuration file. So the multiple configuration file, if you have, means you can see the difference between first configuration file and second configuration file, and easily you can roll back using this configuration archive and rollback. Okay, so configuration. So first we need to configure where we want to store our configuration archives. When you use the path command, you can see what options we have. So this is the screenshot. Okay, so the configuration archive and rollback concept cannot be implemented in the simulator. So simulator means like a Cisco Packet Tracer or JNS3. So you can do this protocol in real devices. If you have real devices, means you can test it, this concept. So I will take snapshot. So I will configure in the real device. So I will take the snapshot and I will show it to you. So this is the first snapshot. So in router global mode, I have to give archive is a keyword. I'll give enter. So it enter into the archive configure mode. Then I have to give path. So path means where the configuration file should be stored. So whether we have to give write command, or it will be automatically taking backup configuration file, means which location that configuration file it will be stored. So in my question, I mentioned flash memory. So flash memory is in router itself, we have flash memory. In that flash memory only the file should be stored. So first we have to go to the global mode. We have to give archive. Archive is a keyword. So just give that archive command and enter. Now the router entered into the archive config mode. So from there we have to give path. Path is a keyword. Then we have to give question mark. So in that question mark we can see either the configuration file should be stored in flash memory, FTP, HTTP, HTTPS, PRAM, RCP, SCP, slot 0, TFTP. So here I will use flash memory, because in my question I lost, it will be stored in the flash memory only. Okay. So normally an external location would be a good idea, but to keep things simple, I will use the flash memory of my router. So normally external location is a very good, but for simple thing I will create in flash memory itself. Okay, so the syntax for creating flash memory, the syntax for storing that configuration file in the flash memory is, so just go to that router config-archive mode, then you have to give path is a keyword, space flash-colon is a keyword, next router-backup. So the router-backup is a user-defined name, so whatever name you want you can give it here instead of router-backup. So here I am using router-backup. Okay, next one. Each configuration archive file will start with router-backup in the file name. So each and every configuration file name should be start up with router-backup, because I mentioned router-backup. Okay, besides the destination, we also have to choose when we want to create a configuration archive. So whenever we are configuring configuration archive, we have to choose the destination where the file should be stored. So that's that point only they are saying here. Next, for example, whenever the running config is saved as a startup config, might be good idea to create backup. So for an example, whenever the running config file is saved, so the saved as a startup config, so might be a good idea to create a backup. Okay, so the configuration archive and rollback. So here I mentioned in config-archive I have to mention write-memory. So this is a syntax. If I am giving write-memory, means whenever I will save that configuration, it automatically take up the backup. This is the first point. So I will also configure a schedule. For example, to create a configuration archive each 24 hours. So here I mentioned two things. So first thing is I have to mention write-memory. So second thing, I mentioned time-feedir 1440. So the time-pdr is a syntax, then it's a number. This number indicates the minutes, how many minutes. So 1440 minutes means every 24 hours the configuration archive will take up the configuration file backup, as well as whenever you can save that configuration, either you can give write command or copy running config startup config. So whenever we are giving these two commands, the configuration file will be saved. So that time also it will take configuration backup, as well as every 24 hours it will take the configuration backup. So using these commands, so this is the syntax to configure write-memory as well as time-pdr 1440. Okay, so after configuring configuration archive, you have to check the show commands. So in router privilege mode, you have to give show space archive. Show space archive, it will indicate how many backup configuration file will be stored. Here nothing is stored right now. Okay, next, copy running-config startup-config. So either you have to give this command or either you have to give write command. So if you are giving this one, means the configuration file will be saved. So here I just save that configuration file. Now you can see again I am giving show archive. So using show archive, the one configuration file should be taken backup, that will be stored in the flash memory. So here we can see flash:router-backup, because I mentioned that name as router-backup, that's why you're showing router-backup. Okay, next one, I have to check that file in flash memory. So in router privilege mode, I have to give show space flash:. So this is a syntax to check the flash memory. So here we can see 840 length and router-backup. So the file name will be stored here in flash memory. Okay, so now I will show you to you the difference. So in starting itself, I will show you one example topology, two router R1 and R2, and in R1 one loopback is there. So previously I did not create any loopback in R1 router. So now I will create the loopback in R1 router. So interface loopback 0, then I will assign the IP address as 1.1.1 255.255.255.0. So why I am creating this loopback, means before creating loopback, I saved that configuration file. So now after creating loopback, again I will save that configuration. So then only I will show you to the difference between first configuration and second configuration file, because first configuration file I did not create any loopback. So in second configuration file, second backup configuration file, before taking second backup configuration file, I will create the loopback. Then only I will show you to the difference between first backup and second backup configuration file. Okay, so now again I will give copy running-config startup-config. So why I am giving each and every time I will save that configuration means then only it will take the backup configuration. And one more thing, I mentioned the time schedule as a 24 hours, so every 24 hours once only it will take the backup configuration automatically. So that's why I have to give manually write command. So copy space running-config as well as startup-config. Okay, so after creating this loopback, I will save that configuration. Now again the configuration file automatically taken backup. So here we can see most recent. So whenever it will showing the most recent means that is the latest backup file. So this one is first flash colon router-backup one. So this backup configuration file, there is no loopback interface is there because I did not create any loopback, then I save that configuration. So that will be stored in the router-backup one, and afterwards I will create the loopback and assign the IP address, and again I will save that configuration. So again the router will take in the backup, that is router-backup two. Okay, so we now have two configuration archive, but we don't know the difference between them. So now two configuration archive is there, backup file is there, we don't know the difference. iOS tells us that second one is the latest version. So in that Cisco iOS tells the second one as a latest one. Here we can see most recent latest version, but this does not always mean that it is the best configuration that we have. So we cannot assume that is the best configuration that we have. So luckily there is a command that tells us exactly the difference between the two files. So luckily we have the configuration, luckily we have the command to tell us exactly the difference between the two files. So how we can verify the difference between the two configuration file? So the syntax is, in privilege mode you have to give show space archive space config, so everything is a keyword, then space a difference space flash colon router-backup-1, that is first backup configuration file name, then space flash colon router-backup-2. So this is the syntax. So using this syntax, so what is the difference between first router backup configuration file and second router backup configuration file? So here we can see plus interface loopback 0 plus IP space address 1.1.1 255.255.255.0. So this is the difference. So what they are saying means when compared to the first router-backup-1 to router-backup-2, in router-backup-2 in that configuration file, additionally we have that command interface loopback 0 IP space address space IP address 1.1.1 space 255.255.255.0. So this is the difference, and this is the syntax show archive space config space differences space flash colon router-backup-1 space flash colon router-backup-2. So using this we have to check the difference between these two configuration file. So the plus symbol tells us the second file has some additional line. So plus symbol tells the second file has some additional line, that is router-backup-2. So I created that loopback interface, so it's showing up air with the IP address. Okay, so if you see a minus symbol, then it means those lines have been removed. So if there is minus symbol means these lines are removed, if plus symbol means these lines are additionally added. So that's the difference. Okay, now we can replace our running configuration and select one of our snapshot like this. Okay, so now I am replacing the current configuration to the old served configuration. So old served configuration is backup router-backup-1, and current running configuration startup configuration for this router is router-backup-2, that configuration file only. In that configuration file only, the loopback is there. So now I am rolled back to the router-backup-1 configuration file. So we have to do, so using this syntax, we have to roll back. So config space, so in privilege mode, config space replace space, everything is a keyword space flash colon router-backup-1 space list. So if I'm giving this command, means it will be rolled back to the router-backup-1 configuration file. So here we can see, are you sure want to proceed? I will give yes. Now the configuration is rolled back to the previous configuration. Here we can see no interface loopback 0 and IP, the interface loopback 0 is removed. So before creating loopback, I will save that configuration. That configuration is saved as a router-backup-1. Afterwards, I will creating loopback and assign that IP address. Again, I will save that configuration and it will create it as a router-backup-2. So right now in that router, router-backup-2 configuration only there. So I am rollbacking to the router-backup-1. So that means without loopback, I will be rollback. So it will be automatically rollback to the router-backup-1 configuration file. So that's why the loopback 0 interface is removed. Here we can see rollback is done. Okay friends, so using configuration, archive and rollback, we can achieve this concept, achieve this task. So now we can see again question, is it possible to take backup configuration automatically? Yes, we can take backup configuration automatically using configuration archive concept, and we have to mention the time frame window also, time schedule also. So if you are mentioning time schedule, time window as a 5 minutes or 10 minutes, means every 10 minutes once without giving running command, without giving save that configuration, it will be automatically taking backup. And also we have to give particular duration, that is a particular duration. And also whenever we can save that configuration also, it will take the backup. So if it says, then which concept is used to perform this task? So already I told you, configuration archive concept only. Okay, configuration file should be saved in a flash memory only, don't use any external server. So we can store in the flash memory only. So next one, is it possible to compare the previous configuration and current saved configuration file? Yes, so we can compare previous and current configuration file. So while you are comparing, so if it's plus symbol means what are the lines are additionally added. If it's minus means that both lines are missed from the previous configuration. So likewise we can compare. So is it possible to roll back from the current configuration to the previous configuration? Yes, we can roll back. So using this command. So using this command, we can roll back to the previous configuration. Okay friends, I hope this concept is very useful to you. So thank you for watching my video. If you have any queries, please ping me. Thank you for watching my videos. Subscribe my channel for further updates.